Hey guys, welcome back. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy 2021.
Everyone's here. It's a full house. We have Bola, we have Maddie. And are we excited, girls? Did you all have a good New Year's Eve?
It was a safe, quiet, very grown-up New Year's Eve. Finally, some point in life it had to happen. COVID has made it happen.
Yes.
Yeah. It's the first time I'm spending New Year's with family. Like, I haven't done that in, like, maybe, say, 20 years or so, or maybe more. I've actually never, like, you know, once one moves out and goes and starts working and all, I've never done that. And now it's the first time, so my parents are also feeling a little lost around me. They're like, yeah, aat ho gayi hai, but, like, what are we supposed to do with her now?
Who is this extra person?
Who is this person?
Well, do we have a place for her at the table? No, very cute.
This is nice. I think Joe's also had a family New Year's Eve after a while, right?
Actually, I did about 2 years ago and it felt weird. But this time it was like I'm staying at home only. So
it's the same level of weirdness then this year.
So it's but it's nice. Yeah. It's always good to know your loved ones are around you and lots to be grateful for all that.
Nice. That's true. Anna? That's true. I mean, everybody being safe and sound wherever they are, whichever corner of the world, is a source of deep, you know, solace this year. It truly is.
We made it to 2021, all of us.
Yes.
That's good.
And the dumpster fire of the year that 2020 was is finally behind us. I don't know if 2021 changes anything drastically, but I'm happy to put 2020 behind me.
At least the hope is there. Yeah,
that's true. There's always the hope that it can be better. Yes.
So one good thing of 2020 was this channel. So for that, I'm grateful. Thank you guys for watching and
this has been a fun experiment, and it's also been very encouraging to get messages and support from all of y'all. So it's nice. It feels really nice.
Yes. So we are continuing on this journey now with a with a song that I've specially picked for you know, to start the new year with, because I've heard loads of good things about this track. It is from someone we really like. His name is Karma. So this is a song we watched his documentary, Maddie, while you were away. He just has such a real, you know, story and where he comes from and how he got into this. So he lost his father a few years ago, and this song he wrote I think within a few days of losing his father. So it's really come from deep within, and he's he, from what I hear, I could be wrong about this, it could be a rumor, but apparently Raftaar saw this song and then invited him to join Kalamkar after seeing this one. So I've heard it's got all the right vibes to start a new year with. And it's called Agar Main Hara Kal. So let's
jump in.
Let's do this.
Yeah. Everyone ready?
All ready? Set.
Okay.
Count me now.
Chalo.
Count
us down. Yes. 1, 2, 3, play.
अगर मैं हार अकल हुआ बेसहार अकल मैं गिर के फिर से उठने को हूँ बात ये बता रहा कल की कल का क्या भरोसा कल को किसने परोसा जितने भी हैं काम छूटे आज ही निपटारा कल मैं जा रहा कल दूर परसों देखना है जग मुझे अब मुझे दे सलहा भी सब मुझे बेगुनाह भी अब मुझे कह के निकले सब मुझे 4 साल से कभी नहीं हारा बेस्ट ऑफ लक मुझे अगर मैं हार अकल ढूंढू गर सहार अकल तो ये कभी मत सोचना मेरा अब कभी नहीं आ रहा कल आई प्रॉमिस फिर से आ रहा कल दोबारा फुल तैयारी से और परसों घी से खाने को मैं आज सूखी खा रहा कल मैं मारूंगा कभी ना कभी कुछ नहीं होता अच्छाई से हारूंगा कभी ना कभी मैं वाकिफ हूँ सच्चाई से अब हारूंगा तो हारूंगा क्या कर सकते हैं होनी का पर लाइफ में लड़ना ऐसे जैसे फिल्मों में लड़ता टोनी जा धोनी का शॉट बंदा रहा था मुझको जो सीखा बल्ला छूटा उससे पड़ोस का फूटा टीवी सोनी का ऐसी हरकत करके सोचे वो साले धर्मेंद्र है ये शोले है मैं गब्बर हूँ ले गोली का मोनिका तू है सारा शहर लायन के नाम से जान तो मुझको हालांकि नाम हो रहा है आराम से शुरुआत से कुछ ऐसे लोग थे जिन्हें दिक्कत थी मेरी शुरुआत से ऐसा कह के मेरे साथ के लौंडे निकले मेरे पास से थोड़ा नाम जो कमाया है यूं खोने नहीं दूंगा हिप हॉप सुनने वाले को यही मैं कहूंगा कि मैं तुम्हें भूल जाऊं ये हो नहीं सकता, और तुम मुझे भूल जाओ, ये मैं होने नहीं दूंगा। अगर मैं हारा कल हुआ बेसहारा कल, मैं गिर के फिर से उठने को हूँ, बात ये बता रहा, कल के कल का क्या भरोसा, कल को किसने परोसा, जितने भी हैं काम छूटे आज ही निपटारा, कल मैं जा रहा कल दूर परसों देखना है जल मुझे, अब मुझे बेसलहा भी सब मुझे, बेगुनहा भी अब मुझे, कह के निकले सब मुझे, 4 साल से कभी नहीं हारा, बेस्ट ऑफ लक मुझे, चाहे मैं 100 लोगों से मिलूं, 200 लोगों से मिलूं, 400 लोगों से मिलूं, या 900 लोगों से मिलूं, मैं चाहता हूं कि वो सब मुझको काम से पहचाने, इज्जत से देखें, चाहे मैं 2 लोगों से मिलूं। अगर मैं हारा कल वो होगा मेरी गलती से, मैं हारूंगा जब मिलूंगा मुझसे भी ज्यादा संकी से, मुझसे भी ज्यादा संकी, मिलना थोड़ा मुश्किल है, बस क्या है ना जमाना थोड़ा बुद्धिल है, अभी तक जो भी किया मैंने, जो भी लिखा मैंने, जो भी गया मैंने, मुझे लगे वो कम है, गम है, जो तेरे मन में छुपा है उसकी दवा मेहनत मरहम है, दम है तुझ में, सबको पता है, रब को पता है, तो सबको उठा और सबको बता, और सबको बता के तू भी नहीं कम है, हाथ पे हाथ रखे कुछ नहीं होने वाला, हाथ पे हाथ रखे खुद मुंह में जाता नीनी वाला, फीके सपनों में रख बनना, कोई हर्ज नहीं, कोई जुर्म नहीं, या खुद ही करना पड़ता है, ये जिंदगी है फिल्म नहीं। अगर मैं हारा कल हुआ बेसहारा कल, मैं गिर के फिर से उठने को हूँ, बात ये बता रहा, कल के कल का क्या भरोसा, कल को किसने परोसा, जितने भी हैं काम छूटे आज ही निपटारा, कल मैं जा रहा कल दूर परसों देखना है जब मुझे, अब मुझे बेसलहा भी सब मुझे, बेगुनहा भी अब मुझे, कह के निकले सब मुझे, 4 साल से कभी नहीं हारा, बेस्ट ऑफ लक मुझे।
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. It's nice to see him as a, he looks like fresh.
As
he looks like a baby. He's Vivek, he's not Karma there. But you can also see the potential in him, and it kind of is a validation of why he is where he is when you listen to this track, right? Because I haven't heard his earlier music. Yeah. So that was the first thing that, you know, I was like, oh my god, it's like looking back at old pictures and saying he looked so young, he was so young. So
yeah, but you can see the determination on his face, mm-hmm. like in his eyes, like I'm going mm-hmm. to keep at this and not give up, mm-hmm. you know.
So if right? this is the track where Kalamkar picked him up, you know, where Raftar saw him and said, interesting, samajh mein aata hai, like, you know, it's totally yes. justified that he must have been like, but ladke mein dam to hai, aaja, you know,
exactly
wala.
Yeah, as far as his rap skills go and his writing skills go, on point, but also as far as his thought process and, you know, what he's saying in the song, like, you know, haath pe haath rakhne se muh mein nawala nahi jata, and mm-hmm. ye film nahi hai, ye real life hai, and main karunga bhi, girunga bhi, lekin khada fir hunga, so I have to still, I can't mm-hmm. be scared of falling down, I have to keep going. So his thought process is very mature, right?
Also, you know, I'm really happy that you've picked this song also for the New Year's bit of it, because it's a fact, the way last year has gone for all
True.
Of us, this year
True.
In many ways True. We are looking, we all want to be motivated, we are motivated, but mm-hmm. sometimes every now and then you feel, you know, we can't go forward. So in that
yes.
sense, Vivek has gone through so much to become Karma. So in one sense, that is like a very cool motivational thing, that that's where he used to be. And today we all know what Karma does, right?
True.
So that transition from there to there, yes, all of us also in this new year, we're just going to be like, yeah.
Yeah.
No, but let's talk
song.
About the lyrics now.
The lyrics, we'll have to pull it out. He did the so many references to Hindi movies, and then in the end,
movies,
he says ki
yes.
ye movie nahi hai, ye real life hai. So yeah. I think he kind of wanted to have that
yes.
come back
yes.
to it in the end, no? because too many film characters were named in the start, and I was like, oh, he's clearly got a Bollywood kira.
Correct.
True. Maddie, what I... sorry, before Maddie begins, I think there's a rawness to this, which like, you could see that, achha, yahan pe he can go tighter. Karma would not have done this. Yahan pe he could have been tighter. Like his transitions also came later in the song. Initially, there was like this nice rhythm pattern that was going.
The rhymes were happening.
Suddenly, there were 2-3. Yeah. And then in the end, 2-3 times, he changed quickly. If you would have just paced it out, which today, I'm pretty sure with Kalamkar, he would have done for sure. Like in, this is like the earlier stuff. So it's like, you can see that. That's lovely.
I'm glad you pointed that out, Shruti, because there was one, right? Main 100 logon se milu, 200 logon se milu, I'm like, here, you're just filling up space, you know, because when you listen to the three lines, you're like, okay, this, I think clearly it's being written to fill up space, which I completely agree. Today, if he went back and heard that song again, he would change the lyrics, right?
Exactly.
There were places where you can see that, you know, I mean, rapping initially starts out as rhyming, right? The most basic thing is you want to rhyme your lines, and then you start adding layers like jazz, right? You want to add a thought process, you want to complete the arc of what you're thinking, then you want to also make very clever references so that every time somebody listens, they get something to it, and that starts with you just starting to rhyme. So you can see the simplicity in the song, because it also is indicative of where he was in his journey as a writer and as a rapper. So I think that was, I thought it was adorable. You
it
know,
was
like
cute.
If someone, it was cute. Yeah, it was cute.
He's known for someone who's got like really good rhyme schemes. So, and that's his starting point. He clearly started in that comfort zone as a writer. He's come a long way from what we've seen in his newer songs. But like you were saying, the whole process of writing and then adding the layers and all of that, the final thing is to fit it in the meter and to get that right, no? Which a lot of people then they write well, but wo meter mein nahi baithta hai. So I think those lines that we felt were just added to fill up the empty space.
Yes.
You know, it was cute. It was really cute to see the process he's kind of, he's followed in the past.
Another thing. Like, you know, another thing that kept coming to me, which you had said earlier, where you spoke about how, you know, he wrote the song and probably recorded it only a couple of days after he lost his father. So then it feels very like how much pain must have gone redirected of emotions, you know, all the stuff he must be feeling, how much of it he would have poured into this song and how internally grueling it must be. So I can't even imagine it. Like, you know, as an artist and as a person, just seeing him perform it, That internal pain, you can see it on his face, but you also know that a lot of it is still inside. It's not out. So, which was very interesting to watch when you know the backstory. If you don't know and you're just watching the video just as is, it's very different. Like, you know, that was interesting.
And the thing is, even in his documentary, we saw that part, like I teared up when he was talking about what happened with his father. And then within like, I think it was somewhere around the new year only that, you know, it all happened. And then they cremated him and all of that. And then suddenly he's the man of the house. He's the oldest son, and he has to take responsibility. So all those thoughts and all the emotions and all of that is coming in this, because he's clearly talking to himself, right? And motivating himself that it's going to go on. Life is going to go on from here, and I've got to pick myself up, even though all these rough patches have come my way and all of this. So yes, the emotion is obviously very high, and it's written from a deeply, deeply personal space.
I think you've captured it really well, because one of the things that's happening is, since you know the backstory, it's also him not only talking to himself, but it's also kind of putting it out there that I know what I'm doing. I am going to be accountable. So one of the things that I really liked what came out of the lyrics of what he was trying to convey was this underlying theme of accountability, right? It was throughout the song, there is this theme of accountability and taking responsibility for what he wants to do, his actions, and through that, his destiny and his journey or the path that he wants to carve out. So it almost also seems like this is also something that he's saying to maybe others around him. And I don't want to stretch it as far as saying that naysayers or anything like that. But I think it's also about him saying that I got this, you know, I am going to man up. I am going to, this is me now. Let me do my thing. you know. So I think it's a dialogue that's also he's having with himself, but I think he's also putting it out there that, you know, I'm an adult and I'll take responsibility for my actions. Whatever I do, I'll own it. So I think there is that sense that I got from the song, which I thought was very commendable, knowing the backstory.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, at any point in time, anyone listens to this song, they will feel what he's feeling, and they'll also be like, yeah, I gotta man up and I gotta level up and
or woman up.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
true. Or human up.
Human up. We'll invent a new phrase today. That's all human up. So I think perfect. I picked well.
Yeah. Well done.
On this very human level, once again, Happy New Year to everybody and to you girls. Happy New Year.
Let's hope 2021 gets all of us to get off our bums and do useful things and good things.
Yes.
Hopefully. One can hope.
Yes. Thank you, guys.
But Madhura, before we say bye-bye, Madhura, we are going to see more of you. Na? You're going to keep coming. You're not going to like just vanish again on us. Na?
No. I will. I cannot promise like the diligence with which I would appear. But I think this is a space that's a fun space for me. So I'll still keep popping in. So I will not be an Eid ka chand. I will probably be like every few weeks. I will pop in. That's a promise. It's more like full moon, new moon.
People have spent the last couple of months saying aapka aur Maggie ka beef ho gaya hai beef.
Sure. That's the only thing remaining is that we'll start putting out diss tracks or diss reaction videos for each other, right? That will be so meta.
Just for followers, that too.
Yes.
Otherwise, we'll be like, arre, while eating popcorn, we'll be like, suna, jab maine ye likha, tumne kya bola?
Exactly. Let's start doing that then. Diss reaction videos. That's because of the beef.
That will be too funny.
Now my slow motion bye-bye is beginning.
Slow-mo has begun. Okay, guys. To the next one.
Bye-bye.
Bye.